بالوت بالوت من دوك سابت بيك ايوك غير دوماتيك اي كي جيسو سوزامين تسبح الساعة الثالثة من يوم السبت القدم المسيح ملكنا ولهنا وفقيرا اسكن جوكي بس ارسلهم صامرين لطاعت الوكين نيز بسم الله بنصرون من يسيرين بكرون
Prayer of the sixth hour offered to Christ, our King, who beseech him to forgive us our sins from Psalm David the prophet and the King. May his best Mabana Solomon Allah. Doxosios Iovos, Holy, 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 the Gospel according to St. John, may it be with us, Holy, me.
When the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name has come, he shall teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all things that I have said unto you. My peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. Not as the world gives do I give unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. You have heard how I have said unto you, I go away and come again unto you. For if you love me, you would rejoice, because I said, I go unto the Father, for my Father is greater than I. And now I have told you before it comes to pass, that when it comes to pass, you shall believe. I will not talk much with you, for the prince of this world comes, and has nothing in me, but that the world may know that I love the Father, and as the Father gave me commandment, so I do. Arise, let us go from here. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Each branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, he prunes, that I may bring forth more fruit. Now you are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me and I in you.
Glory be to God. We worship you, Christ, and as good your good Father and Holy Spirit, because you came and saved us. You Holy Spirit, Lord, whom you sent forth upon your head, this time is our apostle, and thou art not taken away from us, a good one, but renew within us. Create me a clean heart, O God, and then you are in spirit of me, God, casting away from your presence, and not take your spirit away from me.
Now
you have a spirit upon your disciples, and our apostles said, thou art not taken away from us, O good one, but we ask you to renew within us, O Lord, which is the Son of God, the Word, light and living spirit, the spirit of prophecy and chastity, the spirit of holiness, righteousness, and authority. O the Almighty One, for you are the light of our souls, we give light to every man that comes into the world. Have mercy on
us.
To cause, Mother of God, you are the true vine, word, the cluster of life. We ask you for your grace, for the apostles, for the salvation of our souls. Blessed the Lord our God, blessed the Lord the Abadi, we praise our efforts, God of our salvation.
O Heavenly King, the Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who is present in all places and fills all the treasury of good things and the Life Giver, graciously come and dwell in us and purify us from all defilement, O good One, and save our souls. Just as you were with your disciples, O Savior, and gave them peace, graciously come also and be with us. Grant us your peace and save us and deliver our souls.
Amen.
May we stand in your holy sanctuary. We are considered standing in heaven. O Theotokos, you are the gate of heaven. Open for us the gate of mercy.
Holy God, Holy Master, Holy
Our Father, art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven.
Holy, 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 the gospel according to Saint Matthew, may his best be merciful. Amen.
And seeing the multitude, he went up on the mountain. When he was seated, his disciples came to him, and he opened his mouth and told them, saying, blessed are the poor in the spirit, for that is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst, for their righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemaker, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteous sake, for that is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they were found and persecuted and say all kind of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad. For great is your word in heaven for those who persecute who before you. You are the soul of the earth, but if the soul loses its how shall it be seen? It's good for nothing, but you be thankful. And under the earth, you are the light of the world, the city itself in hell cannot be hidden. Nor did I light a lamp put under a basket, but on a lampstand. But it gives light to all who are in the house. Let your light so shine before men, for they may see your good works to glorify your Father in heaven. Lord, you answer him.
We worship you, Christ, because you're the Father and the Holy Spirit, because you came and saved us. Amen. For you were the 66th hour with me to the cross for the sin which our Father had best committed in the paradise. Still done that, you are sinned through Christ, our God, and save us. I cry to the Lord, and hear me. God, hear my prayer, and let me give my petition. Be attentive to me, and hear me in the evening and the morning of midday. I say my words, and hear my voice, and deliver my soul in peace.
Lord
Jesus Christ, our God, who was driven to the cross, and the 6th hour, and killed sin by the tree, and by your death, he made alive the dead man, whom you created with your own hands, and had by the same put to death our pains, by your healing and life-giving passion, and by the name with which you are named. Rescue our mind from thoughts, so Christ leads, and work with us to the remembrance of every commandment. According to your compassion. O Lord, deliver us and forgive us our sins for the sake of your holy name.
Thank you.
God will bear the sins of the whole world, hear us and have mercy on us. Holy Amen.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison,
Oh, seven exhausting. choice of a not even Sotiris Christos, we thank you for everything, concerning everything and everything, for you have covered us, helped us, accepted us to yourself, spared us, supported us, and have brought us to this hour.
Pray that God may have mercy and compassion upon us, hear us, help us, and accept the supplication and prayers of his saints for that which is good on our behalf at all times, and make us worthy to partake of the communion of his holy and blessed mysteries for the remission of our sins.
Lord, amen.
The goodness of lover of mankind, grant us to complete this holy day and all the days of our life and all peace with you, all fear, all envy, all temptation, all words of Satan, the counsel of wicked men, and the rising of enemies hidden and manifest. Take them away from us and from all your people, and from this table of faith that is yours. But those things are profitable, do provide for us with you, have given the authority to tread on serpents and scorpions, and have known the power of the enemy of his soul.
Aroma, ah, 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 ah
Finally, brethren, whatever things are true, whatever things are noble, whatever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are of good report, if there is any virtue and if there is anything praiseworthy, meditate on these things. The things which you learned and received and heard and saw in me, these do, and the God of peace will be with you. The grace of God the Father be with you all. Amen.
Now the fruits of the righteous is sown in peace by those who make peace. Where do wars and fights come from among you? Do they not come from your desires for pleasure that war in your members? You lust and do not have, your murder and conflict and cannot obtain. You fight and war, yet you do not have because you do not ask. You ask and do not receive because you ask amiss, that you may spend it on your children. Adulterers and adulteress, do you not know that friendship in the world is a union of God? Whoever therefore wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. Or do you think that the scripture says in vain, the spirit who dwells in us yearns jealousy, but he gives more grace? Therefore he says, God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Do not love the world or the things in the world. The world is passing away, and so what he who does the will of God abides forever.
Hare Mame O.
Thank you.
who are invested with the grace of the Holy Spirit, may their blessing be with us all. Amen. And after some days, when Felix came with his wife Drusilla, who was Jewish, he sent for Paul and heard them concerning the faith in Christ. Now, as he reasoned about righteousness, self-control, and the judgment to come, Felix was afraid and answered, "Go away from now. When I have a convenient time, I will call for you." Meanwhile, he also hoped that money would be given him by Paul, that he might release him. Therefore, he sent for him more often and conversed with him. But after 2 years, Porcius Festus succeeded Felix, and Felix, wanting to do the Jews a favor, left Paul bound. Now, when Festus had come to the province, after 3 days he went up from Caesarea to Jerusalem. Then the high priest and the chief men of the Jews informed him against Paul, and they petitioned him, asking a favor against him, that he would summon him to Jerusalem while they lay in ambush along the road to kill him. But Festus answered that Paul should be kept at Caesarea, and that he himself was going there shortly. Therefore he said, "Let those who have authority among you go down with me and accuse this man, to see if there is any fault in him." And when he had remained among them more than 10 days, he went down to Caesarea. And the next day, sitting in the judgment seat, he commanded Paul to be brought. When he had come, the Jews who had come down from Jerusalem stood about and laid many serious complaints against Paul, which they could not prove. While he answered Paul himself, "Neither against the law of the Jews, nor against the temple, nor against Caesar have I offended any in anything at all." But Festus wanted to do the Jews a favor, answered Paul and said, "Are you willing to go up to Jerusalem and there be judged before me concerning these things?" So Paul said, "I stand at Caesar's judgment seat, where I ought to be judged. To the Jews I have done no wrong, as you very well know. For if I am an offender, or have committed anything deserving of death, I do not object to dying. But if there is nothing in these things which these men accuse me, no one can deliver me from them. I appeal to Caesar." Then Festus, when he had conferred with the council, answered, "You have appealed to Caesar. To Caesar you shall go. The word of the Lord shall grow, multiply, be mighty, and be confirmed in the holy church of God. Amen."
In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Today is the ninth day of the month of Ramadan. May God bring it, begin it in goodness and heal it for us in peace and tranquility, while our sins and iniquities are forgiven through the tender mercy of our Lord, O my Father and brethren. Amen. On this day of the year 50 AD, Saint Conan departed. This saint was from a city called Antonius in Syria. Heathen parents who worshipped the stars. When he grew, he heard the preaching of the apostles, so he believed and was baptized by their hands. Many virtues and purity, chastity and mercy were manifested in his life. His parents wished for him to wed, but he refused. They forced him to marry, but he agreed with his wife to keep their virginity and lived as such for a period of time. God granted him the gift of performing miracles and casting out evil spirits. He attracted his parents, his wife, and his parents to the faith of the Lord Christ. The saint preached the gospel, and many of the heathens believed at his hand. One day, one of the unbelievers went to a pagan temple to offer a sacrifice to the idols. When Saint Conan knew this, he entered the temple and entreated God to uncover the truth to this man. A voice came out of one of the idols declaring that the idol was the work of Satan and not a god. All the people who were present cried out, saying, "One is the God of Saint Conan." And they believed in the Lord Christ and were baptized. When the deputy of Emperor Claudius Caesar heard about the account of the saint, he brought him and proposed to the saint to worship the idols, but he refused and confessed his faith in the Lord Christ. He commanded to bind him and be severely beaten. The people of the city who were present jumped over. The soldiers freed the saint from their hands, brought him to their house, and took care of his wounds until he recovered. When he finished his good strife, he departed in peace. The believers made his house a church and laid his body in it. from which many signs and wonders were manifested. The blessing of his prayer be with us all. Amen. On this day also the martyrdom of Saint Adrianus, Martha, his wife, Eusebius, Arminius, and 40 martyrs. They were natives of Rome. They suffered many tortures, for they refused to worship gods made of gold and silver, and they shouted, saying, "We worship one God, the Creator of heaven and earth, our King Jesus Christ." They were all beheaded by the sword, and they received the crown of martyrdom. The blessing of their prayer be with us, and glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.
Agios venchois, Isus Bene, Christo serene.
Yeah.
to saintly disciples, holy apostles, many prophets and righteous men have desired to see things which you see and have not seen them, and to hear things which you have not heard them, but bless your eyes for they see, and your ears for they hear, so be worthy to hear and act according to the gospel through the prayers of your sins.
Pray for the Holy Gospel.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember also our Master, all the sublimest, remember then our supplications and prayers which you offer up unto Lord our God. Those have already honestly before them, those who are sick, heal them, because you are the life of a soul, the salvation of a soul, the hope of a soul, the healing of a soul, and the resurrection of a soul.
Two minutes.
Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and Amen. As we are gathered in this weekend, with God's grace, we will be discussing the Word of God and how to benefit and its importance. And just in today's reading, there is something worth noticing how we deal with the Bible. So I'm just going to allude to it and leave you with it, and we, in the lecture, maybe we can dig more into it. So, while our Lord was giving them a parable, it's not something factual happened, but he comes back and he says, verse 42, Jesus said to them, have you never read in the scriptures the stone which was built, the builders rejected, has become the chief cornerstone? This was the Lord doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. So what I want to refer to is, while there's a lot of history and historical, it is not about history only, it is not about morals, it's about Christ. And Christ is manifesting himself in every part of the Bible, in different ways. You know, we ourselves sometimes like to, if we can say, have different kind of dressing, different kind of appearance, right? So God, out of his love and his care, he appears in so many different ways. So we have to make sure this is the last, is not like explaining a sermon, and then he said, didn't you guys read? So he's making a cross-reference. He was giving them a parable. Just to give us an idea that a parable being said is is the same like a historical event that happened, that we should have an attitude of not only knowing some morals of the story, not morals of the story, but to meet with Christ. And this will be the theme. The theme, God willing, throughout the day or day and a half we have, is how to make sure that we really have a meeting with the Word, a meeting with Christ. That's what the calling is for, a meeting with Christ. So, supposedly tomorrow is the Feast of the Cross, that's why we're not going to have a regular reading, but typically with the church lectionary, tomorrow is the Samaritan woman. Okay, and what's happening here, different ways to look at it, but I wanted to remind you with the idea here, did you guys listen to the parable carefully? So about this vineyard owner, and he expected fruits, and he been sending servants asking for fruits, and the people just killed like all the servants and killed the owner's son. Okay, the idea of God's people rejecting and others are what? Accepting. So we see the Jewish people are rejecting, and a Samaritan woman will believe. A Samaritan woman will benefit from Christ, while the Jewish people who have Christ all the time, they're not benefiting. Yesterday, I don't remember what was happening exactly, but a very common word about how people who are convert, that God works with them wonderfully. And the question is God who is working with them wonderfully, or is it about them receiving from God what he's given? Is it God having kind of favoritism? He's dealing wonderfully with certain people, or it's about our reception to God's gifts? He's giving abundantly to each one of us, but we are the one who are depriving ourselves. So this text is a good example of how to read the Bible, and you see the parable, and you get something out of it, and you relate it to the Old Testament, and you read the history, and you get something out of the history, and you connect everything together, and you see, God, give me not to reject you, not because you are humble, not because you come in a way that probably is not very clear. I end up rejecting you, and rejecting you one, two, three, four times. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. God is coming to us in this holy days of Lent, and let us accept him into our hearts, to whom the glory forever and ever.
Yeah.
The Father, O Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, who has completed the gifts of the world of mankind, remember all the peace of God, Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
Lord, mercy.
Jesus, from one end of the world to the other, all peoples and all flock, bless the heavenly peace sent down into all our hearts, even the peace of this life, graciously grant to us, the leader, the armies, the rulers, the counselors, the multitudes, our neighbors, our coming in and our going out. Adorn them with all peace. O King of peace, grant us your peace. For you have given us all things. Acquire us to yourself, O God, our Savior. For we know none other but you. Your holy name we utter. May our souls live by your Holy Spirit. And let not the death of saints have dominion over us, you, we, your servants, nor over all your people.
Lord, have mercy.
Goodness, the lover of mankind, remember the high priest of Patriarch, Baba Batadros II, and his partner, Bishop Abadabi.
Lord, have mercy.
Bless the Bishop
of
them, secure for us for many years and peaceful times, fulfilling that holy archpriesthood with which you have entrusted them for yourself, according to your holy and blessed will, rightly handling the word of truth, shepherding your people in purity and righteousness. And all the Orthodox Bishop, the Regiments, priests, and deacon, and all the fullness of your one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, grant them and us peace and safety in every place. Their prayers, which they offer on our behalf, and on behalf of all your people, as well as our prayers in their behalf, receive them upon your holy rational altar, the sweet savor of incense, as your enemies. All the enemies, visible and invisible, tremble and humiliate under their feet speedily. As for them, keep them in peace and righteousness in your holy church.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, our assemblies, bless them.
Lord, have mercy.
Grant that they may be come to us without obstacles, that we may hold them according to your holy and blessed will. Houses of prayer, houses of blessings, houses of purity. Grant them to us, O Lord, and to your servants who will come after us forever. The worship of idols utterly uprooted from the world. Satan and all his evil powers, tremble and humiliate them under our feet speedily. The offense and the instigators abolished, let the dissension of corrupt heresies cease. The enemies of your church, O Lord, as at all times now also immunate, strip their vanity, show them their weakness speedily. Bring to naught their envies, their intrigues, their madness, their wickedness, and their slanders which they commit against us. O Lord, bring them to all to no avail. Despair their counsel, O God, despair their counsel of Ahithophel.
Lord, have mercy.
Arise, O Lord God, let your enemies be scattered, and let all who hate your holy name flee before your face. But let your people be in blessing, thousands of thousands, and 10,000, and 10,000 being in good for the blessing.
Amen. λιπόσι. Και το πνεύμα της.
Ο Author of Life and King of the Ages. O God, unto whom every knee bows, those in the heavens and those on earth and those under the ears. To all our humble and under the yoke of servitude, bowing the head to the scepter of his kingship, who is glorified by the angelic host and the heavenly orders and the rational natures with unsilenced voices, declaring his Godhead. And since you were pleased that we frail earthly men should also serve you, not on account of the purity of our hands, because we have not wrought goodness on earth, but rather desiring to give to us the undeserving riches of your purity. Receive us unto yourself, O good and lover of mankind, as we draw near to your holy altar, according to the multitude abundance of your mercy. And make us worthy of the heavenly peace which befits your divinity and is full of salvation, that we may give the same to one another in perfect love and greet one another with a holy kiss.
Peace, love, and the Holy
Apostolic
Greeting. Not with a vile sin that defies your fear, nor with thought of guile fill the wickedness of the traitor. For our conscience is not bent on evil, but rather by the eagerness of our souls and the rejoicing of our hearts, having the great and perfect sign of the love of your only begotten Son, and cast us not behind, we your servants, on account of the defilement of our sins. For you know, as creator of our being, that no one born of a woman shall be justified before you. So make us worthy, our Master, with a holy heart and a soul filled with your grace, to stand before you and to bring unto you this holy sacrifice, which is rational, spiritual, and bloodless, into the remission of our transgressions and the forgiveness of the ignorances of your people, for you are compassionate and merciful God.
Greet one another with a holy kiss. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Hear, Lord, our Jesus Christ, Son of God, hear us and have mercy upon us. Offering order, stand with trembling, look to the east, let us return.
Iten neveres veiente, tisioto, kos, solam maria, shoisariem, ot nan, vikoe, volite, et novite, nosce, moco, veres, os, nem vegiote, alatos, nem vegnem, maes, o, erge, at, i, at, soti, mon,
Okay.
being master, Lord God of truth, been before the ages, and reigning forever. Who dwells in the highest and looks upon the lowly. Who has created the heaven, the earth, the sea, and all that is therein. The Father of our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ. By whom you have created all things visible and invisible, who sit upon the throne of his glory, and who is worshipped by all the holy powers.
You who have seen it,
before whom stand the angels, archangels, the principalities, the authorities, the thrones, the dominions, and the powers.
Look to your cities.
You are here, around whom stand the cherubim full of eyes, and the seraphim with six wings praising continuously without ceasing, saying,
the cherubim worship you, and the seraphim glorify you, proclaiming.
Yourself to us for sitting in the darkness and the shadow of death. Through your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, of the Holy Spirit and of the Holy Virgin Saint Mary.
Yeah. has appointed a day for recompense in which you will appear to judge the world in righteousness and give each one and one.
We believe that this is true. Amen.
We look up toward heaven to God who is Father and Master of every.
Till I come.
from the dead, his ascension into the heavens, and is sitting at the right hand, O Father, and his second coming, which shall be from the heavens, O Son, full of glory. We offer unto your gifts from what is yours, for everything, concerning everything, and everything.
Worship God in fear and trembling. We praise you.
Father, the Pantocrator.
salvation of this holy place, which is yours and every place and every monastery of our Orthodox Father.
Lord, have mercy.
And those who dwell therein in God's faith pick.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember those abroad brought unto this gift, those who have been brought, and those by whom they have been brought, give them all the heavenly rewards.
Pray for these holy precious gifts,
our
sacrifices,
when
those who bring them.
Lord,
command of your only begotten Son, that we share in the commemoration of your sin. Graciously uphold the Lord to remember all the sins who have lived you since the beginning. Our Holy Father, the patriarchs, the prophets, the apostles, the preachers, the evangelists, the martyrs, the confessors, and all the spirits of the righteous, who perfected in the faith most of all the pure flow of glory, ever Virgin, Holy Theotokos, and Mary, who in truth give birth to God the Logos. Saint John, the born Baptist, and Martyr, Saint Stephen, the Archdeacon, the Proto-Martyr, the Builder of the Supper, the Poor Apostle, a Martyr, the Patriarch, Saint Severus, our Teacher, Deus Corus, Saint Athanasius Apostolic, Saint Peter, thy Priest, a Martyr, Saint John Chrysostom, Saint Sergius, Saint Theophilus, Saint Demetrius, Saint Cyril, Saint Basil, Saint Gregory the Theologian, Saint Gregory the Underworker, Saint Gregory the Armenian, the 318 assembled at Nicaea, the 150 at Constantinople, and the 200 at Ephesus. Our righteous Father, great Abba Antony, the righteous Abba Paul, the three sins Abba Macari, and all the children, the cross bearers. Our Father of Israel, the Egumene, our Father of Abishui, the righteous perfect man, the beloved of our good Savior. Our Father, Paul of Tamon, Ezekiel, his disciple. My Master, the Roman Father, Saint Maximus and Domitius, the 49 martyrs, elders of she, the strong Saint Abba Moses, John Kami, the priest, our Father of Daniel the Gumin, our Father of Isidore the priest, our Father of Ochon the Canaanite Theodore, his disciple, our Father of Ashundar, Shundra, and Abawisa, his disciple. Our Father of Abraham, the Bishop of Mekhid, his disciple. Our Father, Pope Corollus the Sixth, our Father, Habib Girgis, the Archdeacon, and all the choir of your senseless prayers and supplications, have mercy on us all and save us for the sake of your holy name, which is called upon us.
Let those who read recite the names of our holy fathers, the patriarchs who have fallen asleep. O Lord, repose their souls and forgive us our sins.
Put them in the paradise of joy, in the region of the living forever, in the heavenly Jerusalem, in that place. And we too, who are sojourner in this place, keep us in your faith and grant us your peace unto the
to the ages of all ages.
stay into your kingdom. That as in the souls on all things your great and holy name may be glorified, blessed and exalted, and everything honored and blessed with Jesus Christ, your beloved Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Before Pontius Pilate. Fasting and prayer are those which the righteous, the cross bearers, pursued, and they dwelt in the mountains and deserts and holes of the earth because of their great love for Christ the King. And we too, let us fast from all evil, impurity, and righteousness, and let us proceed forth to this holy sacrifice and partake of it with thanksgiving, so that with a pure heart and lightened soul and unshaven face, a faith and fame, a perfect love and a firm hope, we may dare with boldness without fear to cry to you, O Father, who art in the heavens. And say,
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Christ Jesus our Lord, grant us the kingdom of God, glory forever and ever. In Christ.
In abundance because of my own sins, and the abomination of my heart deprive not your people of the grace of your Holy Spirit. O God, absolve us, and absolve all your people from every sin, from every curse, from every denial, and from every false oath. For our Master, grant us a reason and a power and understanding to flee unto the end from any evil deed of the adversary. And grant us to do what is pleasing to you. Grant us to do what is pleasing to you at all times. Inscribe our names with all the choir of your sins. The peace of the one hand. All those who ask us to remember, those who are penitent, those who are confessing. يا رب السجود أمامك. Remember, O Lord, our assemblies, bless them.
Save the men and with your spirit in the fear of God, let us attend.
Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
The whole is for the holy. Blessed be the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God. The sanctification is by the Holy Spirit. Amen.
One is the Holy Father, and one is the Holy Spirit. One is the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Et
omnem baptismum.
Gesadnu paddas vadamun karim haqiqil yesu al-Masih ibn ilahin.
Amen.
And the true blood of Jesus Christ, the Son of our God. Amen.
Amen.
Soma. Nempes nubinti men wil pinuti fai pechen omis mi. Amen.
Amen.
Giving flesh, that your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, took from our Lady. The Lady was all the authority of the cause, Saint Mary, in between the divinity, without mingling, without confusion, without alteration. He confessed the good confession before Pontius Pilate. He gave it up for us upon the holy wood of the cross of his own will for us all. Truly, I believe that his divinity parted not from his humanity for a single moment in front of an eye, gave the cross for salvation, remission of sins, and eternal life to those who partake of him. I believe that this is so and true. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. I believe that this is so and true. Amen. Pray for us and all Christians who such was concerning them. Remember us in the house of the Lord. The peace and love of Jesus Christ be with you. Sing hallelujah. Pray for the word of communion of the Immaculate Heavenly and Holy Mysteries. Lord, have mercy.
Doxa Sine.
Bye. Which an eye has not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered the heart of man, the things which you, God, have prepared for them that love your holy name, and have revealed to the little children of your holy church. Yes, O Father, this is a pleasure before you, for you are merciful, and we send up unto you glory and honor, O Father, Son, Holy Spirit, now to the age of ages. Amen. Bow your head
before
your servants, O Lord, who are serving you, entreating your holy name, and bowing down their heads to you. Dwell in them, O Lord, walk among them, aid them in every good deed. Wake their heart from every vile earthly thought. Grant them to live and think of what is pertaining to the living, and understand the things that are yours through your only begotten Son, our Lord, God, and Savior, Jesus Christ, whom all we and all your people cry out, saying, have mercy upon us, O God, our Father. Sacrifice ascending to the heaven. Remember us in front of the Lord. Forgive us our sins. Let us pray with the angels, saying, glory be to God the Father. Peace on earth and goodwill toward the men.
Amen. Alleluia. Zum Sabbatri. Kei yoke. Aniot me. Mati. Kei kai. Kei sosi. Ona.
Establish us for peace, and forgive us our sins, and make us worthy to be sent to the saying, our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Now, welcome back, everybody who came this morning. Thank God that you.